Hello friends, I'm KK, Kekesha. I want to talk about pranayama. Not many of us practice pranayama because we don't understand the importance of our breath or the breathing system. Pranayama is a Sanskrit word. It's a third limb of yoga and out of eight. And prana means energy, life force energy that travels through our breath into our system. We take prana through the breath, we take prana through the food we eat and the environment we live in. There are many ways. But breath is the first to take prana into your system. That's the universal energy we breathe in. Yama means control. So why do we want to control the energy? Because when the energy is not balanced in our system, we suffer in many, many ways. From the time we start to sense our lives, we want to create balance in everything, almost everything. Because we know that balance will create harmony, balance will create synchronicity in our system and in our lives. Not too much and not too little. Have you ever thought why do we have two nostrils? We have two nostrils to balance the energy. So the right nostril and the left nostril. It keeps switching every 60 minutes or about 70 minutes to balance the energy of the body. So to understand the balance, you can say right nostril, left nostril, ha, tha, sun or moon, solar energy, lunar energy, masculine, feminine. There are many ways to understand the balance. So when the breath is disturbed, our energy is out of balance. And the breath is so important because every cell is breathing in your life. Why the breath is disturbed? The question is why the breath is disturbed. Breath is affected by every single maybe feeling and emotions. It is affected when you're stressed or when you're busy, happy, joyful, angry, upset, sick, in love, whatever going on in your mind, it just affects your breath right away and all the time. Plus, it is affected with every single move you make with your physical body. And breath is also connected to your thought, because this is the only connection between mind and the body. The breath is the only connection. No breath, no you. So cheer up. The breath is need to be under control and we can work on it for a better breathing. So the loop is every single thought which is born in your head affects your breath, and breath is reaching out to every single cell of the body. So it means every cell is breathing, every cell has its own energy, ATP, every cell has a memory, it has DNA except your nails and the hair, and you're alive because of your breath. So breath is so important in our life. It's the first thing we breathe in when we come in this world and we breathe out when we leave the world. All our lives we are just surviving on the number of breath, not the number of years. You are not breathing. It's breathing itself all the time. It is available for free. For free. If you want to make any change in your mind or control the mind, breath is available for free for you. For all of us. So the breath is so powerful. It's feeding the body. It's feeding the mind. It is almost impossible to change the mind first, because it's not available to notice. You cannot sense the mind, you cannot feel the mind, but breath is available to feel and sense right here within yourself all the time. For thousands of years, yogis are using breath control, not the birth control, breath control in their lives to control the mind. So it's the technique we use in our breath. We also, to control the mind, we use also mudra, mantra, gazing, which is drishti, dhyana, which is meditation, and we use yoga nidra and many ways we try to control the mind, but breath is the first. We take many actions, many measures to create better lifestyle. Lots of workout and balanced diet and other stuff, but sadly we don't take any action towards improving our breathing tools, for example our lungs, our breathing passage and mental state. All of that stuff comes together when we practice our pranayama. We talk about heart health a lot, but where the heart health is coming from? The heart health is coming from the better breathing system, better lungs. When the lungs are functioning better, it's feeding all your systems in a perfect way and working in harmony. So it means all your organs improve, your immune system improve, your heart health improves, everything improves in the body. Quality of the breath matters. It is the only thing that feeding our system at first. There are two ways to improve the breathing tools. You don't have to be yogi to do that or practice yoga. It's just a simple way to enhance the capacity of the lungs. One is super slow breath, which is going to take more oxygenated blood into your system and facilitate your body. It's like it's called yogic breath. So you take very slow prana in and very slow out. It's going to calm your nervous system. There are techniques to do that. But you can just, as a non-yogi also, try to just breathe in and out, starting with 6 count inhale and 6 count exhale. And then you can improve up to 1 minute. The second way is forceful pranayama. Forceful pranayama means exhaling powerfully. Naturally, if you exhale too much and with power and force, the next inhale is going to be better and more powerful. According to the science, we are using 30-40% of our lungs in our 70 years of life. The rest of the lungs are sleeping all our lives. We can enhance or improve the quality of our breath by increasing the capacity in our lungs, which is very much possible with our breathing techniques. Yogic breathing techniques, there are Tai Chi breathing techniques, there are Kung Fu breathing techniques, they are all very wonderful and amazing, and they are all interconnected anyway. So the technique is to exhale normally, inhale with your nostrils and then make a smallest hole in your mouth to blow the air, like if you are inflating the balloon, and this technique is gonna draw the diaphragm in and create pressure. You're going to shrink your lungs towards the spine, and the next exhale is going to be better. It's very powerful, very good technique. The thing to talk about right now is any muscle, scientifically any muscle you use is going to build. Lungs don't have muscles, but the intercostal muscle in your ribs, diaphragm, abdominal muscles and the neck muscles all are supporting our breathing system in expansion and in the length of the lungs as well. So forceful exhalation is you can do just like I just told you, and you can also actually use the balloon. If you want to check your breath, the energy in your breath and the strength of the breath, there is a spirometer. You blow the air in the spirometer and the ball moves further. This is how you check the strength of the breath. In my teacher's training, my first take on the pranayama class is to give balloon to my students so they can really enhance their function of the lungs and then the quality of the life. After that, when we practice pranayama, the breathing techniques, it's going to really work better for you, 100% for you. So if you blow the balloon, and please, this is not a group practice or group activity. Try to do it in isolation, especially nowadays. And take care of your hygiene, clean and everything, and private equipment for yourself. So if you keep blowing the balloons, you're gonna improve the lungs and the breathing tool, which is your lungs, your chest, your neck muscles and your breathing passage. Second thing is really funny. To clear the nasal passage, we use, and it's also used in many sports as well. So you close one nostril and blow the air with another color of balloon, not to be confused. It's really funny, but it's really effective. Just try yourself for some time. It's going to open up the entire side which you're using to blow the balloon air in. And you're going to feel really different, and it's really, really cool idea. So try both things, and when you want to try or practice something in your life, it has to be for some time, like for about 7 days, 21 days and more. You have to commit to yourself. In order to receive the results, you need to do it every day and many times a day. Then you're gonna feel the result and do some feel better in your life. So, bye everyone. The yogic prana. Thank you everyone. Namaste my yogis.